This rise in the number of cases puts the Church of England's handling of historic sex abuse under scrutiny. 136 people have sought help from a support group in the past 6 months. This survivor has chosen to speak out.
My sense is that survivors were kind of thrown into the sea of forgetting down through the decades.
This man says he was abused as a teenager by a senior cleric who's since died. He claims for years many in the church did nothing despite knowing about his allegations.
Despite the fact that I told in total, I think it's 5 bishops over more than 3 decades. One of the things that's surprised me and upset me is that despite telling so many senior people, there's no trace, there's no record of my having told anybody in the past.
The church has set up new safeguarding procedures, but some survivors say they still offer too little help too late.
We are told that they have been promised some action or being promised a response, and then they are left and nothing happens.
Justin, by divine providence, Archbishop of Canterbury.
The current Archbishop, Justin Welby, has said helping the survivors of historic child abuse is one of his priorities. He set up a new unit to help victims and is introducing new safeguarding legislation.
If we go back periods of time, undoubtedly, we did not respond the way we should have done. And I don't think we are there yet. So there will be cases where people will feel we haven't responded as well as we could. We want to get better, and we are committed to getting better.
This survivor accepts that some progress has been made, but he says the church has much more work to do to help the increasing numbers of survivors now coming forward in need of help. Penny Marshall, ITV News.